Hey, I'm Brendan Moran for Cree Currents. I'm out here at the Boundary Oak Golf Course for the grand opening of their new tap house. Let's check it out. Tim Roberts, he's the golf course liaison to the city of Walnut Creek. Tim, a lot going on today, right?
A lot going on. Long time in the coming too. The community's really been pulling for the tap house to be done over the last several years. So we've been closed for about 5.5 months. And what you see today is what we're gonna be able to enjoy for a lot of years to come.
Tell me about the tap house.
The tap house probably started back about 4 or 5 years ago with the grill and obviously this great location we have and the community coming up here to eat and not just golf but hang out. Mm-hmm. We really wanted to present the community with something nice. Obviously with Walnut Creek's restaurant and retail scene, you know, it's competition for people's business and, you know, this is a city asset. So we put this in the works probably about 4 years ago, you know, budgeting and studies and finding the right partners and finding the right layout and how we want to do it. It took about that long. Mm-hmm. And then for the last 5 months, we've been under construction and it came out great.
So you've got a tap house because there's beers on tap, yes?
There are 12 local beers on tap and then some of the usual suspects that you'll find, you know, regionally. It's been well received as the tap house.
So this is a city asset, right?
The city owns the property, the city owns the golf course, the city owns the building and basically all the equipment, assets you see on the property. The citizens back in 1964, 65 put together a bond measure that we could finance building a golf course on the easternmost area, obviously nestled up against the hills. This was a tougher area to develop and it was an ideal place for a golf course. So we're celebrating our 50th year. We have a great managing partner in here who runs the day-to-day operations for us. That's Corsco. All our staffing here, all our sales, all our food and beverage is all managed by them, but yet the city retains this, the building, the property, and everything as obviously a super valuable asset.
And the tap house is kind of the culmination of a couple years worth of work, right?
For sure. This goes back probably about 4 years ago. Pros Commission, our golf committee, we really wanted to jazz the place up. It was time for a facelift. It was time to rejuvenate the food and beverage up here. The original plan was actually flipping the two locations between the pro shop and where you see the tap house now. Feasibility just didn't work out. So we took the time to make sure we got the right design, the right partners, the right feel to open up a full retail restaurant experience to the golfers. Obviously, we've got a great community here in the Northgate region and obviously the east side of Walnut Creek. But we really want to showcase this to the entire East Bay area that, hey, you can come up here and get a great meal, a good beer pairing. We've got a full bar. Mm-hmm. We've got a great selection of wines, including a lot of local wineries, and most of the beers are local.
Great.
Yeah.
And you're open till 8?
We're open till 8 o'clock every night, which is actually new for us because traditionally, we may have been closed at 6:30. We might have been open at 7 o'clock, depending on the traffic and whatnot. But with the investment the city's put in the property, we've made the commitment to run it and staff it as a fully retail restaurant experience. So our neighborhood folks can say, hey, it's 6:30, I don't feel like cooking. They can drive right up the hill, come to the tap house, get a great meal, sit outside on the deck, all the outdoor seating we have now that that's all brand new, and they can come up and have a great dining experience. And with that view of the city, it's tough to beat.
So with all the work you've been putting in here, how's your handicap?
My handicap is my handicap. That's the problem. That number fluctuates too much. So I enjoy getting out here and playing. I played my first round out here, a couple of childhood friends of mine. My first round was in 1984. I came up here and I was hooked and I've been playing golf ever since. And it's a fun, relaxing game that my wife and my daughter are getting into now. So we can come up here on every fourth Friday and have a buffet dinner with the community every Friday from May, June, July, August, and September. We do a 9-hole grouping and a dinner pairing afterwards. It's really affordable. It's only $45. So you can come out and play some casual golf with your friends and then come inside for a meal and it's all inclusive.
So this is a city-owned golf course. Is there anything for residents specifically?
Yeah, actually as part of the bonus of being a Walnut Creek resident and being part of the, you know, building this place, we do have residence cards that you can come up with your utility bill, your driver's license. You can buy a card for the year, it's only $25. That offers you discounts on tee times every time you come out and play. So it pays for itself. You get a significant discount if you're a resident. You can also get range balls at a discount. Mm-hmm. And it's every other year you need to buy your residence card. And that's good 365 Saturdays, Sundays, and holidays.
Cool. You said you started playing here. Mm-hmm. This is a good place to get started for other kids. Yes?
It's a great place to get started in the game of golf. With the instruction team we have here, with Dave DeLong's been here for I can't tell you how many years. We are qualified instructors that work from the average golfer to the professional golfer, but the future of the game is the kids. And with our first tee program up here of Contra Costa County, we're one of the locations. We have our LPGA girls program up here. We have a junior golf program up here. And several of the schools use us for their golf teams. A few of the elementary and intermediate schools. And then we've got three high schools up here that compete on a regular basis as their home course.
There's more here than just golf and the tap room, right?
Oh yeah. When the city developed this, they wanted to, obviously we talked about being a community asset, but upstairs we have, room for major weddings. We've got an outdoor wedding venue here that we're right in the middle of working with a design team right now. So in the late fall, we're gonna redesign our entire wedding outside facility. We've got awesome banquet facility upstairs. We've got many different sizes. You can have a wedding of 50 people, a party of 50 people, a celebration of life we do here all the time for our community members. And we host weddings here for up to 300 people in multiple rooms upstairs with incredible views. The food and beverage staff here is excellent. Chef and his team, both my sisters got married here. So I speak from experience when I say it's a great family atmosphere. It's a great community asset. And we encourage people to come up here and take a look for their next event.